But in this wire also there are atoms that cannot move outside of the crystal lattice. They move, their movement is mainly vibration, and they vibrate around the position in the lattice. This vibration increases with temperature. When the temperature increases, the atoms move more and more, and this means that the electrons scatter with the atoms. So, when the temperature is high, the atoms avoid the movement of the electrons, and that means that the resistance of the wire increases. So, the higher the temperature is, the higher the resistance is. This is a way of measuring temperature. So, here we have the temperature that we want to measure on our thermometer. As I said before, a voltage has to be applied. It means that a current goes through the resistor. When a current goes through a resistor, there is a dissipating heating that changes the temperature of the sensor and changes the reading of the thermometer. So, what is the difference between the real temperature and the temperature measured by the thermometer? This is what we want to analyze in this talk. And here is, there is the model that the difference in temperature is a function of the square of the current, the resistor, and a self-heating coefficient. And this self-heating coefficient is, again, a function of two things. One of them is the internal design of the thermometer, and the other thing is the external surrounding of the thermometer. In this talk, we are going to analyze the influence of the current in the self-heating error, the influence of the surrounding environment in the self-heating error, also the influence of, if there is any influence of the radiation shield in this error, and Radek from Czech Republic Meteorology Institute is going to speak about the wind speed influence of the on the self-heating error. For doing that, the three first points, we have then perform measurements with different thermometers, PT100 alone and PT100 inside the temperature and humidity sensor. And we measure the resistance in baths, in fixed points, and in climate chamber. The correction model that we use for evaluation, the self-heating error, is the extrapolation by making measurements with the resistance with two currents. We perform mainly the measurements with these two currents, 3 milliamps and 1.5 milliamps, and we measure the voltage drop in the resistance with an anemometer. Well, if we start to analyze the measurements, first of all, the influence of the current. The current is probably the most significant factor in self-heating effect. In the first graph, we can see that the self-heating increase